This is Wilman Ziyada, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film. And today, once again, on translation is the amazing Chu Chen, in direct from China, an acclaimed poet and artist, the one and only Zong Tingfeng. Zong Tingfeng, you have so many incredible publications within the poetry sector. I want to know, first and foremost, where did you begin your journey with poetry? And of the many poetry publications you have, are there a few that come to mind as being nearest and dearest to your heart?
Thank you, Will. 宗老师他幸运能采访到您，他知道伟知名的诗人、作家，所以呢就想知道您是什么时候发现自己对诗歌非常的感兴趣，然后呢能不能跟我们分享一两个您最喜欢的诗集或者是诗篇？
我呢，从小呢，就是说对这个文学艺术一直都是很感兴趣的，阅读呢，从小学的时候呢，我就从可能就读长篇小说呀这样子开始，然后呢，就一点一点的，就是对文学的兴趣就是逐渐的就起来了嘛。后来我上到西安美术学院以后呢，就。 因为对现代诗歌的阅读啊，然后呢，很突然的就是激发了我对这个诗歌写作的这个热情。我觉得就是说，它对我内心的一种表达需要啊，非常的契合。这样我就从上美院期间就开始写诗了，然后一直就这20多年，然后就这样一直就醒过来。哎，诗呢，这么多年吧，就是说我自己一直对一首诗。 就是我这个诗集里面的第一首，叫《你是理所当然的父亲》。这首诗是我自己特别喜欢的，是关于生命起源的一个表达。这首诗呢有点长，我就念上一两段吧。你是理所当然的父亲，你树啊，大地荒凉的年代，河川都已断流。 青草、沙耗和黑刺丛也都枯死了，道路两旁还扼臂了蒙古人的骆驼和脾气刚强的北方贱牛，但你依旧高大挺拔，你灌溉庄严，根子深深扎进了高原的泥土，你的根茎何其坚牢，苗已何其繁茂，你从不知道什么叫做贫乏。 而今我谦卑地开口，为你吟诵这篇朴素的诗歌，赞美你的荣耀。我的诗句何其踊跃，何其喜悦！亘古以来，你就是树中之树，群山之间最具威严的王。你也是黄河两岸这些鲁莽村庄理所当然的父。我的祖先和父辈。 以及我们都在你有力的荫蔽之下生而育女，开枝散叶，把这生命之火传递，根基日益牢固。我们领受你的垂爱，绝不比群山间的其他生灵为少。而你日益融入时间深处，将成为缄默的秘密。你的金色浓荫在傍晚时分。 深深的垂下，香气吹拂的大地。哎，这是第一段，有点长，我就念到这儿了吧。好，谢谢啊。
下背后的灵感。
这首诗呢，就是说，因为我的家乡呢是在陕西省的北部，叫陕北黄土高原嘛。那个环境呢，就是说它这个生存比较艰辛，就是自古以来啊，那个地方它。 那个环境就是比较艰难嘛，那个经常缺雨呀，那个风沙又大，然后呢，就是说无论人眼吧，那个植物眼吧，在那都生长得特别不容易。现在呢，陕北就是说它这个自然环境好一些，人不断在那种树，植被情况能有所改善。但我小的时候呢，那就是说在那能见到一棵绿树都是非常非常不容易的，生命的那种。 艰辛啊，那种不屈努力啊，这个就是说我从小就是，那特别能够 注意到，因为一大片的那个黄沙嘛，对吧，你突然看到一棵树，那是人的心情是特别喜悦的啊。所以呢就说这个印象呢，在我就说生命的自身的那种就是美好，然后呢以及它的那种就是那个生扎根在大地上的那种向上挺拔生长的这种努力啊，这种力量也不能说努力吧，就是说它自身它非常有力量，而且呢就尽管就是说它长得不容易，但是呢那也参天大树它也是有的，就是说它可能有就是说有几百年的那样的那种大树啊，那这我看到的时候呢是非常非常震撼，因为很少见嘛，它不是森林对吧，那么大一片群山中间偶尔你能看到一棵特别大的树啊，就特别的震撼，特别的感动，从小这个印象就很深刻，然后呢和我的生活以及对生命的感受联系起来，有一天呢就是说自然而然的就有了这首诗的那种写作，很一个晚上吧，一气呵成，然后呢就是说有了这首诗啊，多年以来就是我自己很喜欢这首诗。
好的，非常感谢。Well, he was a big fan of art and literature as a young kid, and when he went to college in the Xi'an Academy of Fine Arts, he was drawn to contemporary poems, and he found this expression a very great outlet to really showcase his mind. And so start from that, he began to write poems, and it's been 20 years that he had been a poet. And his favorite piece is this one called 你是理所应当的父亲, which loosely translates to You Are My Father Deserved. And he dedicated this poem to his mother, motherland, which is the northern part of Shaanxi. And so before he was giving a short recitation of the poem from his collection. And in the poem, he discussed the origins of life. And so when he was younger, the North Shaanxi was pretty much a barren land. And there's so much sandstorm, and there's lack of rainfall, and there's no trees, very little vegetation. So somehow when he saw this one giant tree amid all the sand, it was a shocking moment for him. It was a touching and it was a joyful moment as well. And he was moved by this life force of Mother Earth. And I think that that's what prompted him to write that poem. He said he did it overnight, just one night. And it's actually his favorite poem.
Oh, I love that. Wow, and what a great backstory to that as well. Well, speaking of art and literature and just surrounding yourself with all of this creativity, you live in an artist's village. I want you to talk a little bit about the name of it, the significance of it, because it is very, very well known in the East, specifically in Beijing.
Thank you. 宗老师，他接下来一个问题是想知道，因为您现在是在方面继续创作我们的诗集，然后呢，他知道宋庄是中国一个非常重要的一个艺术村落，所以能跟我们简单介绍一下宋庄它的名字的由来，还有它的重要性吗？在尤其是在我们亚洲的艺术史上。
宋庄呢，就是本来呢，它就是说是北京的通州区的一个镇子。这个小镇的名字就叫宋庄，以前呢，在中国当代艺术家聚集这个村庄之前呢，就是这个村庄呢，它也就普普通通嘛，啊，但是呢，就上个世纪就是这个当代艺术兴，这个当代艺术潮流兴起，也是逐渐的啊，从北京周边很多的这个小的一个村落啊，因为艺术家嘛，他就很多人从全国各地啊。聚集到这周围来，然后逐渐也是自然的形成的，互相艺术家互相寻找，然后呢就是说一点一点的可汇聚起来，汇聚到这个逐渐就是以宋庄为中心，聚集了一大批的这个当代艺术家，这里头有很多那种就是非常好的艺术家啊，然后呢也对当代中国的这个就是艺术的这个当代进程啊， 起到了很大的这个推动作用啊。这个就是说中国甚至世界的艺术家艺术行业的这个很多人呢，他都是说有目共睹嘛，大家都看到啊。现后来呢，就是我呢是在基本上就是有十年前吧，啊，十年就是恰好就是十年多一点吧，啊，我就是到了宋庄，现在呢就在这个地方，以后呢我的工作可能主要的方向就是又朝这个绘画方面要倾斜一些，因为我觉得就是我的写作这方面的需要呢，就是在前面的二十几年呢做的大体上是差不多了啊，以后呢我不是也就上的是美术学院嘛，绘画方面的那个工作呢时断时续的啊，一直没有好好的展开过，以后呢我可能主要想在这方面再做一些工作吧。
非常感谢。Well, 宋庄 it's a town, the name of the town, from Tongzhou. Tongzhou is a city on the outskirts of Beijing. So according to Mr. Zong, in the last century, contemporary art is really taking off in China, and people from all of the country gathers in Songzhuang. So this place gradually gained its reputation of talented people. And so soon enough, not just China, but foreign artists were invited. And so himself, Mr. Zong, came to Songzhuang 10 years ago. And so he said that right now his life as a poet, he thinks it's pretty fulfilled. So he's moving on to create more paintings.
I love it. And final question for you is, I'm so curious about your painting because that's another beautiful aspect of your creative journey. I'm curious to know with your painting, where you gain a lot of your inspiration from.
宗老师，他接下来一个问题是想知道您的绘画的作品灵感主要是来自于。
这个呢就是其实就是我在这个文学艺术方面的那个感知那种就是触角啊，这些东西呢它都是共用一套的，因为它是一个人的不同的侧面的一种感受和表达诉求嘛啊。那么就是我呢更多的倾向于一种就是说内心的一种表达吧啊，就是对外在的对生活对生命的一种状态啊。我更侧重的就是说在他引发的这种内心的一种回响啊，一种震荡，对这些东西呢我是要把它的表达到作品中间的啊。诗歌那么就是用语言嘛，那么绘画的话呢我可能就会用到这绘画方面的那种相应的一种思维啊，以及他的手法啊。在那前面在以前的那些年头中间呢，就是我可能主要是侧重于诗歌的表达，就诗歌方面用的时间下的功夫更多一些，绘画方面做的少一点，但是呢就是说虽然作品不是像我诗歌的作品那么多啊，但是呢就是对我来说其实呢就是还是同样都是很重视的啊，我没有觉得就是说这个哪一个东西对我更重要一点啊，因为它都是有时候它是用不同的那个角度去表达的话呢，它总会有一些意外的那种发现啊，表达上的一种喜悦感吧啊，一种它也能够互相渗透，能够互相支撑嘛，丰富啊。
我们可以简单的聊聊，我看到您之前为韩寒的创作过啊。
好的，是这样的，就韩寒本人呢，我是不认识的，就是他跟我的一个朋友吧，可能就是工作上有些联系，然后呢，他那个书有一套作品集，他的那个书的封面呢是就是说通过我那个朋友，然后联系我，就是。 让给他授权嘛，给他授权，然后呢，他的书籍封面他要用我想用一下我的作品做封面的那个图啊，做封面的那个插图。后来呢，就是说我同意了嘛，啊，因为就是文学作家诗人就是天然的，我觉得他们很亲切，因为基本上跟我也算是同行嘛，啊。而且呢，我的画呀什么的，因为是一个诗人的作品嘛，可能韩寒也觉得就是说，跟他的那个文学中间的一些东西呢，可能就是比较的吻合吧，啊，所以呢就是这样，进行了这么一次合作，哎。
好的，非常感谢。So well, to answer your question about painting, he think that the his art sensibility transcends between different forms of expression, between writing and painting. And he portrays things in life that moves him, the power of life, the power of the vital force of the nature. And he thinks that painting and the poem actually complements each other. So he also mentioned this best-selling writer in China called Han Han, who's also the 1980s generation, one of the most popular writer, I think 10 years ago. And Han Han adopted some of his painting into the cover of his, for the cover of his book. And he said that Han Han himself isn't a personal acquaintance, but however, through a common friend, he was introduced. And he think that the two of them, Han Han and himself, had things in common as a literary, you know, someone who really liked literature.
I couldn't agree more. I definitely think that poetry and painting do have a common thread to them. Poetry obviously being of the word, painting being of a visual. But I've always looked at poetry as, if you really look at the sentiment that a person could paint a picture in their mind of the scene. I definitely can see that. Well, listen, I could speak with you forever. I'm so excited, Zong Tingfeng, you are coming on board as one of FENIX360's Global Artist Ambassadors. And once again, I'm so grateful for your time today, Chu Chen. And I cannot wait to hopefully one day come to Beijing and to meet you, Mr. Zong Tingfeng, sooner rather than later. Thank you so much for your time today.